Phantasmagoria is one of those games everybody's heard of. It was released in 1995 by Sierra Online, and despite its mixed reviews, it has become best-selling Sierra game till the date. Sierra gave us absolute gems like Gabriel Knight, Larry, Quest for Glory, Space Quest, and all other quests they've done. Let's find out if Phantasmagoria deserves to bear the Sierra logo. To be honest, it's rather like every other horror film. Couple buys a big old mansion, one of them gets possessed, and the other is fighting the evil, possibly killing their entire family in the process. Pretty basic plot. And Phantasmagoria is exactly that. The only difference is that this movie as a game is a bit interactive, and unlike the movies in cinemas, this one looks really, really horrible. In 1995, an average computer had Pentium processor in it, and some low-end computers still had 486 processors. So I sort of understand why the video resolution is so low, but that doesn't mean I can't bash it. Most of the time it looks really bad, but sometimes you can't even tell the difference between a person or a tree. Phantasmagoria is a horror game, set in some made-up American village with about 5 residents in it. It is divided into 7 chapters. Each chapter adds more and more tension between the main characters. First chapter does a good job of setting up main characters. Adrian Delaney, a successful writer, and her husband, a photographer, Don Gordon. They are a happy couple who just bought a huge mansion in a remote American village. The mansion was previously owned by some kind of magician named Zoltan, who mysteriously died in the very same mansion alongside his 5th wife. It's pretty obvious from the creepy interior that the house was owned by the magician. The game starts the first day Adrian and Don move to the mansion. Since Don is a photographer, he immediately starts rebuilding one of the spare rooms into a dark room. For those not familiar with photography before 2000, dark room is not some room to scare people or something, it's used to develop films, similar to a light room in today's computers. While Don is working in his room, Adrian is combing through the huge mansion. Everything was looking good until Adrian started having nightmares and weird visions all over the house. Mysterious writings and warnings started to appearing and warning her about the evil in the house. Of course, she didn't pay attention to any of those, until they led her to a secret room where she came across an old book, and by reading the book, she obviously woken up some kind of evil demon which possessed her husband. Since then, Don started behaving erratically. He was more secretive, he didn't let Adrian into his dark room, and over time, he was becoming more and more aggressive. From now on, Don spends all the time in the dark room, while Adrian is running about searching the place and meeting new people in the nearby village, slowly getting to know what actually happened in the house, what happened to all Zoltan's wives, that something is terribly wrong with Don, and that evil may actually exist. If you're wondering why it sounds so familiar, Phantasmagoria is almost a perfect copy of the Amityville Horror made into the form of a game. Phantasmagoria is a point-and-click adventure game, where you control Adrian by using hotspots on the screen. Hotspots are there for moving Adrian around and picking up items, which you can then find in the inventory and use later in the game. I don't like how the inventory takes up too much space. It's a waste of space that could have been used for the actual game. It's of course used to interact with various puzzles, which are unfortunately way too easy and simple for an adventure game. I'm sure it was intentional. They wanted the player to better focus on the story and the horror part, but still, it's too easy to call these puzzles puzzles. There's also kind of help on this panel. This dead block here should help you when you're stuck, which is virtually impossible. It doesn't tell you exactly what to do, it just gives you a slight hint, which should be enough for you to keep cracking on.
I am the official hint keeper. I watch your every move. Ask me for a hint if you are hopelessly stuck, but use me sparingly. Too many hints can spoil the game. Someone is behind that tree. Do you dare walk over there?
It was made when games like Under a Killing Moon were praised and quite successful. Everything was shot in front of a blue screen, which is quite obvious if you're not blind, and some Hollywood special effect team helped with that. It's an old game and it shows, but it was state of the art 25 years ago. Sierra claims the game includes more than 1,000 backgrounds. I didn't count them, but it seems to me it's a far cry from the actual number. I gotta say, actors are quite good. Adrian is most of the time believable. She doesn't understand why is Don behaving like a massive wanker all of a sudden. With time and Don's increasing hostility, her patience is nearing to a breaking point. The script is not some kind of masterpiece, but I really like her character's development. What I hate about her though, is when the video sequence ends, Adrian goes to the position of its attention, and it looks bloody awful. You have to look at that all the time. And not only that, nobody hasn't changed clothes from the beginning to an end. I can't imagine the stench in the house. Other characters are not better either. Don was introduced as a loving and cheerful husband, but over time, he is slowly turning into a crazy, hateful wreck of a man. You also get to meet a couple of locals. They'll help you understand the story behind the mansion and the magician who owned it. The dialogues are sometimes weird. When Adrian engages in a conversation, she asks one question, gets an answer, and instead of asking another question, the conversation ends and you have to click on the character again. And even though the dialogue ended like 2 seconds ago, they greet each other once again. What pissed me off during the last chapter was before you enter the last sequence, you need to do a couple of things or you won't be able to finish the game. However, even if you don't do those things, game will let you enter the last sequence even though it's a dead end, where you die countless times in a very graphic way, unless you start over the entire chapter 7. Music is a bit schizophrenic. Video sequences use the music that was recorded live with real instruments, but for the background music, MIDI files were used. Music style varies depending on background and the situations you're in. Unlike the music in video sequences, background music is used to build up tension. I may upload the soundtrack composed of the MIDI part, I'm still not sure if it's worth it. The game was released on 7 CDs. That was a lot in 1995, but MIDI was a standard format for the music at that time. Not only video sequences, but also SVG graphics takes up more space, of course. Is it worth playing? Well, yes and no. If you're an adventure games fan, sure, go ahead and give it a try. You'll have a good time even though it's way too easy. If you're just after the story, just watch a playthrough and don't bother with the game. It's practically the same thing anyway. And that's it. Have a nice day and catch you lot in comments.